You'll find out on this very special program, JoJo's Psychic Alliance, featuring noted psychic astrologer JoJo Savard. And here to tell you more is the host of TV's Jackpot, Chain Reaction, California's Lottery, The Big Spin, and tonight, the host of JoJo's Psychic Alliance, Jeff Edwards.
Thank you very much. Thanks. Welcome. Here tonight, under these fabulous stars and in this special place, you're about to meet one of North America's foremost psychics, the wonderful and gifted Queen of the Stars, Jocelyn JoJo Savard. And you'll find out how her special gift can help you find love and success in your life. But first, I'd like to tell you a little bit more about this remarkable woman. When she was but a child, those around young JoJo realized that she had a psychic gift. In fact, one day at the age of 5, with all the innocence of childhood, she uttered the prophetic, ominous words, "Mommy, hide Bernard in the closet. The angels are coming to take him to heaven."
3 days before he died, she asked me, she told me sometime, put him in the wardrobe, and he's going to heaven, something like that. She was saying that.
Sadly, this dire prediction of her brother's untimely death came true just 3 days later, as his young life was snuffed out in a terrible accident.
But 2 days after, he got killed by an accident.
JoJo's formative years were filled with an interest in astronomy and the natural sciences, and she had a special fascination with astrology, numerology, tarot, and palmistry.
Even as a kid, you know, like as girls, we would play dolls. The fun game she would prefer to do is read palms, and she did that since she was 6, 7 years old. When I was 13, she told me I would have 2 sons. I always wanted girls, and she said, "Well, you're going to have sons," and I just gave birth to my first one, and it's a boy.
And then, as a young adult, during her 20th year, something happened that was to have a profound effect on her. A senseless motoring accident, echoing that which claimed the life of her younger brother, Bernard, nearly claimed hers. After several weeks in a coma, she was pronounced clinically dead. And that's when she had her out-of-body experience. And then miraculously came the faint signs of life. A full recovery took many months. As a result of that near-death experience, JoJo was convinced that she must surely have some greater calling, and so began her quest, an odyssey of discovery that would take her to the remote regions of Tibet, eventually to mystical India, where she learned how to tap into her psychic gift. Today, JoJo Savard shares that gift. As Canada's foremost psychic, she's inspired hundreds of thousands, pointing them toward freedom, happiness, love, and prosperity. Wherever she goes, she says,
"I love you and I kiss you."
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome JoJo, goddess of the moon and queen of the stars. Thank you. Oh, look at that. That's lovely. Thank you. Welcome. You know, we're talking about this being a magical place. Indeed it is it not?
Magic, pure love.
Yeah.
I am so happy to be here.
Now, you must tell me about the out-of-body experience. How did that affect you?
It gave me freedom. It made me feel, I fell in love with me. I fell in love with life. And when it happened, the feeling, it took me quite a while to figure all this out because that was quite a very big, heavy thing for me. And but
sure,
it was great. Like I always say, the negative leads to positive. Believe me, that's the truth. You know what you are. You know what I am? You know what you are. You're a big one. We all are a big genie in a bottle. And if you rub life positively, you could make all your wishes become a reality.
Now, you really believe that that can happen?
Are you kidding? My life is that way. And I'm telling you, when you connect to love, when you connect to the spirit, that's mm-hmm. the whole key. It's to connect with the spirit, and you go back inside, and when you look for the universe, look inside. And you're going to find the universe. And within the universe, you have total abundance and anything you want, because you're the child of creation. You have within yourself the power to achieve any dream at all. And there's no dream, no ideal that is too extraordinary for any human being to achieve. And if you look at people who really succeed in life, they are the ones who really believe in themselves, and they connect with the inside power, the universe, and they make things happen.